thing. Let's lift his name on high. Come on, Zion, we praise our King. Let's celebrate.
Thank you. Praise the Lord, everybody. Hallelujah. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for the Lord is what? Good. And his mercy. Anybody grateful for God's mercy on today? Can you just wave your hands? Are you glad to be in the house of the Lord again? For this is the day that the Lord has made. We got to rejoice and be glad in it. Come on, stand to your feet as we get ready for altar prayer. Is anybody grateful for this Palm Sunday? Hallelujah, hallelujah. The Bible instructs us, let everything that have breath to do what? Praise ye the Lord. Your praise may not look like mine, but as long as you have breath and you are ready to praise ye the Lord, you are following the commandments of our Holy Bible in the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody, just clap your hands. And as you're clapping your hands, if you don't mind, just go ahead and greet someone next to you. Let them know that you're good to see them, that you're happy to see them. Let them know that it's the Jesus in me that loves the Jesus in you. In the name of Jesus, oh, give thanks, hallelujah. Let us go into the house of the Lord, for he is good. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. It's something about being in this sacred place. Hallelujah, hallelujah. When we all gather together in the name of Jesus, glory, hallelujah. Oh, I'm getting ready to turn it over right now. I am. But I don't know about you on this week, but hasn't God been a great God? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't even want to get into that beginning of, oh, it could be worse or whatever, because whatever's going on in my life, whether you think it's worse than the next person, whatever is going on with me, that's what God has ordained for me. And whatever degree of worse or whatever, that's what God has for me. So it may not look like your situation, but because it's my situation, I know that this feels a little uncomfortable. This don't feel like what I'm normally used to going to. You may have everything going well in your family, in your life. No bills, no sickness. You just praying. You just in prayer for thanks. You just send a Thanksgiving prayer every time. You don't got to ask God for nothing. That could be your season. But even if that is your season, my season is still important unto God. My season is still important unto God, and I say thank you. So right now, we're going to go into our altar prayer. If there's anyone that has a request before the Lord, we're asking that you come and make your way to God right now. You can come to the altar. It sure is. And we're going to have Minister Donna come. She's going to get ready to lead us in prayer. In the name of Jesus, whatever it is that you got to ask God for, whatever it is, there's nothing too great. There's nothing too small. Good to see you. Good to see everybody in the place of God. Even those that are going through your inner moment, your inner time, whatever it is, there is no thing too hard for God. There's no thing too big for God. There's no thing too small for God. There's no thing insignificant for God. Even our young people, you may just be living in your room right now. You just got a room with LED lights. That's all you got to worry about. You don't have to worry about no bills. You don't got to worry about your eighth grade graduation money due on Monday. You don't have to worry about anything, but you are still in your own situation as a 13-year-old, as a 17-year-old. Woo, it don't take much, it don't take much. But when I was 17, there were some things I never ever thought about that my 10-year-old is sharing with me,
that my 13-year-old is sharing with me the things that they've had to battle. And I'm sitting right in the same room with them. But God is so omnipresent. God is so ever faithful, even as parents. We think we're doing everything that we know unto God, and we don't really know the struggle that our parents went through. And I don't even know why I'm saying all this, because I was instructed to just do announcements and prayer. But it's something on me that God is just leading me to share this with you. As parents, as grandparents, the house could be feeling so harmonious. The kids are doing their chores. Yeah, they had a little tone with you, but you've addressed that. You've gone through that. But once that disturbance has been redirected, they go back into their spaces, wherever that space is, whether it's in their room or the living room. But you don't know the thoughts that are coming into their mind that says, you're not enough. You're not valuable. You don't belong to be here. Just take your life. Just end it now. And you would say, not my baby, not my son, not my daughter, because they're into everything. They feel popular at school. And this may not, you know, ring out to you per se. But I'm raising two anointed, chosen by God, very gifted, highly intelligent, talented, but they're still young ladies at the end of the day that Satan desires to sift them as wheat. Hallelujah. But I'm so encouraged that God said, I've already prayed for you. That when your faith fails, they may have never read that scripture. And when I grew up in church compared to when they grew up in church, it is different. But my eyes have been open. And I'm standing here to say, God, I thank you that the plans of the enemy to snatch my children from under us was aborted in the name of Jesus. But God, oh, we the pastor's kids. Oh, they third, fourth generation of preachers. But you know, we a little different now. We allow them to hear different things and see different things. But whatever the case may be, it's come in. And that energy that has come in to say, I'm 10 years old, I'm 11 years old, I don't want to be here no more. I never ever thought that would be a situation that I would have to, you know, even consider. But God does all things well. He does all things well. We serve a very present God. Hallelujah. And so today I see those that are coming to the altar. Even if you didn't come to the altar, whatever your unspoken requests are, you can just lift your hands. We have Minister Donna here, and she knows she's standing as an intercessor in so many different areas, as a caretaker, as a wife, as a student, as a parent, as a grandparent. She has so many life experience, even in this young age, so she's standing in the gap right now. Even our ministers that are out traveling and they're speaking God's word, even those that have a desire to come. The report says hospice, but what does God say? The report says stay inside. The report says sick and shut in. But what does the Lord say? Whose report will you believe? So as you bring your requests unto God, in the name of Jesus, I'm asking that you remember not just our young people, but remember our young people. Remember the child in you that wanted to be heard. But because of our parents' upbringings, they didn't mean no harm. They said, baby, you're going to be all right. Do these chores, go to church, pray about it, and you're going to be all right. They didn't mean no harm. They didn't. But it's 2024. And I don't know about y'all, but my babies are like, Mama, I need to talk to somebody besides you and Daddy. Can you set that up for me? And I sure can. I sure will. But God is so grateful. So we have Minister Donna here. She's going to pray for all the families that are represented. Govern yourselves accordingly. The announcements are on our website at apcmorganpark.org. We have a communion service this Thursday, Palm Sunday. For more information, check the website. We have baptism and resurrection this Sunday. This is the week, as Elder Foster was talking about, our Savior's triumphal entry. This is the week as God was getting ready to meet his destiny. It started way before Palm Sunday, but Palm Sunday is one of those significant celebrations or our memorializations where we are remembering when they cried, Hosanna, Hosanna. And the next week they said, crucify him. But I heard my sister say today, from Hosanna to Hallelujah. Anybody got a Hallelujah anyhow? God bless you. God bless you. In the name of
Jesus. As we go before the Lord, I'm going to ask you to hold your neighbor's hand. Link up with your neighbor. The young people that we have standing at this altar, just encourage them and pray over them. The ones that are out there in the congregation, just pray over them. God, we thank you on this morning, on this afternoon, God. We thank you on this afternoon, Jesus. We say yes to your will and yes to your way, God. Hallelujah. Oh, God, we've gone through a rough week, some of us, God. Oh, God, we faced some things this week, God, that we know without you, we would not have made it. So we say thank you on this afternoon, God, for bringing us together one more time, God, just to commune together, God, just to lift up your name, Jesus, just to exalt you, oh, God. We thank you on this afternoon, God. We say hallelujah. Oh, God, we lay all our cares on you, God. Everything that we've gone through, everything that we've entered into this week, God, we cast all our cares on you, Jesus. Every family, every person that's represented here on this afternoon, God, I ask that you touch them, God, in the name of Jesus. Be with them, God. Oh, God, touch their minds, God, in the name of Jesus. Give them peace in their minds, peace in their hearts, God, peace in their spirit, in the name of Jesus. Lord, prepare them for whatever it is that they're going to face this week, God. Whatever it is that's going to come and try to attack them. Oh, God, cover them and keep them in the name of Jesus. Lord, for we know that it's in your name, God, that there's healing, God. Your name, God, that there's deliverance, God. In your name, God, that there is peace that surpasses all understanding, God. And we thank you, Lord. We praise you even now, God. We don't know what's coming. We don't know what's facing us, God. But we say thank you in advance, God, for keeping us. We say thank you, God, in advance for covering us, God. Oh, God, cover our young people, God. We know, God, that they are facing a new age and time, God. Things that we didn't have to face, God. So we ask that you be with them, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, let them want to proclaim your name, God. In the name of Jesus, want to profess the name of Jesus. Even in the times that they don't know which way to go, they know they can come to you, God. Oh, God, they can come to the rock that's higher than I, God. In the name of Jesus, when they can't talk to their parents, God, touch them, God. Be with them, God. Speak peace into them, God, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you and we call it done in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. As you go back to your seat, you might as well go back with a praise on your lips. It's a little quiet in here for my take. I said, you might as well go back with a praise on your lips. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yeah, yeah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come right here. Everybody clap your hand. Yeah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I said, hallelujah, hallelujah. Y'all say,
hallelujah, hallelujah.
Say hallelujah, hallelujah. Y'all say,
hallelujah, hallelujah.
Come on, if you see, say hallelujah, hallelujah. Say,
hallelujah, hallelujah.
What you say? Say, Hosanna. Say,
Hosanna.
We say, Hosanna.
Hosanna.
That's some praise we give. We say, Hosanna. Yeah.
Hosanna.
Say, Hosanna. Yeah.
Hosanna.
Now, real quick, everybody, just clap your hands right there. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Say, everybody, clap your hands. Yeah. One more time. One more time. We'll say hallelujah, hallelujah. Y'all say
hallelujah, hallelujah.
Y'all got it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Y'all say
hallelujah, hallelujah.
Come on, Sister Tasha. I say hallelujah, hallelujah. Say
hallelujah, hallelujah.
One more time. We'll say hallelujah, hallelujah. Say
hallelujah, hallelujah.
Now, if you got a hallelujah on your lips, give God some glory right there. Come on. The song says, no matter what the problem may be, I'm going to lift him up. Look at the person next to you and say, lift the Savior up. Tell somebody, lift the Savior up. Hey, put your hand right there. If you're not clapping your hands, if the person next to you isn't clapping their hands, make sure they got it. There you go. Hey, hey, hey. Tell somebody, say, we came to lift him up today. Tell them, say, we came to lift him up today. Hey, let's go. No matter, no matter,
no matter what the problem may be,
say,
I'm going to lift him for the whole world to see. I got the victory, for he is my king. He's the reason that I stand.
Let's sing it again. No matter what.
No matter what the problem may be.
I'm gonna lift him.
I got the victory for the whole world to see.
I've got the victory.
I got the victory.
He is my king.
He is my king.
He's the reason. Let's do that again. Let's do that again. Go on, sing it again. No matter what the problem may be, say, I'm going to lift him
for the whole world.
I've got the victory,
for he is
my king. He's the reason. One more time, one more time, one more time. No matter.
No matter what the problem may be,
I'm gonna lift you up.
I'm gonna lift you up for the whole world to see.
I've got the victory.
I've got the victory, for he is my king.
He's the reason.
He's the reason that
he
I
said
king.
If I,
he said if I be lifted up, I'll draw
all men unto me.
All men unto me. I know that I'm gonna lift him up till he flees from eternity.
Let's do this.
He said if I, he said if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me. I know that I'm gonna lift him up till he speaks from eternity.
So here we go, say, no matter,
no matter what the problem may be,
I'm gonna lift him up.
I'm gonna lift him up. For the whole world to see.
I've got the victory.
I've got the victory for
you. Any more victorious saints? Any victorious saints?
The
Let's do it one more time. Hey, say, no matter what.
No matter what. Yeah.
the problem may be,
I'm going to lift him up.
I'm going to lift him for the whole world to see.
Where the victorious saints at? Victory. How are you at this morning? Hey, he's the reason.
He's the reason that I'm
here. He said if I
be lifted up, I'll draw
all men unto me.
All men unto me. I know that I'm going to lift him up till he speaks from eternity.
He said if I. He said it right.
He said it right.
He lifted.
He lifted up. I'll draw
all men on.
All men unto me.
I know that.
I know that I'm
gonna lift him up.
Gonna lift him up till he speaks from eternity.
Let's do it again. He said it right.
He said it right.
He lifted
he
up.
He lifted up. I'll draw all men unto me. I know that.
Real quick, now everybody clap your hands. Hey. Say, everybody clap your hands. Hey, y'all better play over there. Come on, I love it. Come on. Hey. Cool, let's do it again. Hey, hey, he said if I be lifted,
he said if I be lifted up, I'll draw.
One more time. He said it.
He said it. He lifted up. I'll draw all men unto me. I know that I'm
gonna lift him
gonna
up.
Lift
till his feet. Break it down one time. Break it down real quick. Break it down real quick. Real quick. Now you guys got palms in your hand. The scripture tells us that when Jesus came in, they were waving palms and singing Hosanna. Right. Can y'all just wave it around real quick? Come on, let's just wave it around. This is our Hosanna. Now, the only difference with us, we're not going to turn on them next week, right? We're not going to turn on them. We're going to continue to follow them, right? Right? We're not going to cry Hosanna today and turn on them by Friday, right? Here we go. Come on, wave it around, wave it around. There you go. Wave it around. All right, come on. We're going to do it one more time. We're going to do it one more time. He said if I be lifted up.
He said if I be lifted up. I'll draw.
We got one more time. He said if I be
lifted up, I'll draw
all men
unto me. Yeah. I know that I'm
gonna live.
Gonna lift him up till he speaks from eternity.
Here we go. So we say, hey, can y'all wave it around real quick? Wave it around real quick. Wave it around. Wave it around. Wave it around. Wave it around. Hey, wave it around. Wave it around. Yeah. Hey, wave it around, wave it around, yeah. Wave it around there. Yeah. Y'all got it. Wave it around there. I need all the tenors in the house. We're going to sing it like this. We're going to say, lift him up, lift him up, lift him up. Y'all got it.
Higher and higher, lift him up.
Y'all got it.
Lift him up.
Y'all lifting it.
Lift him up, higher.
Come on, I'll talk, join us.
Lift him up. Lift him up,
y'all got it.
Higher and higher, lift him up.
Are they lifting it next to you? Make sure they lift it with you.
Lift him up,
higher,
higher.
Everybody
higher.
Say,
lift him up.
Say, lift him up.
Lift him up.
Lift him.
Lift him.
Say, higher and higher.
Higher and higher, lift him up.
Y'all got it.
Lift him up,
say higher,
higher and higher.
Y'all gotta wave the palms higher. We saying higher, y'all going lower and lower. We trying to make sure they know that we represent Jesus Christ, the one who saved us. Come on, wave it around, wave it around, wave it around now. Wave it around, wave it around, wave it around now. Come on, we higher, higher,
higher,
higher,
higher,
higher,
higher,
say,
higher and higher.
We go higher. Let the band play. Yeah. 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 Y'all clapping your hands this morning. Y'all waving them around this morning. Let me hear you make some noise. One more time. Say higher.
Higher.
Say higher.
Higher.
Higher. Say
higher.
Say
higher.
We lift them up higher.
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 Say higher. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Y'all know how we do it at APC? Hey, come on, I don't hear y'all over here. Hey, over here, I don't hear y'all. Come on, let's go. One more time. Say, lift him up. Glory right there. Lord, we lift you high. Lord, we lift your name on high. No other help I know. I dare you to lift him up. Lift him up. I dare you to wave it around one more time. Lift him up higher and higher. Because God is good. Hey, that's why we lift him up. Y'all not lifting it up with me. Lift him up. Higher and higher. Lord, your name is great. Lift him up. Lift him up. Hey, lift the Lord up. Higher and higher. We'll say, we say, lift him up. Say,
lift him up.
Say,
lift him up.
You'll say,
lift him up.
Say, higher,
higher.
One more time, say, lift
him up.
You say, give the Lord God a praise right there. Yeah. Lift his name on high. I said lift his name on high. Come on, APC. I said lift his name on high. It's a little quiet in here for me. Say, lift his name on high. Yeah, yeah. Lord, we lift your name on high. Yeah, yeah. Come on, because the Lord is good. Because the Lord is great.
Because
the Lord is excellent.
Because
the Lord is magnificent. Because the Lord is the Savior of the world. My sin is gone because of him. My shame is gone because of him. My guilt is gone because of him. The devil is defeated in my life because of him. Demons are trembling right now because of him. Things are changing in the atmosphere because of him. That's why we lift him up. Oh, lift him up.
Come on, everybody, lift your voice in the room. Lift your heart. Lift your hands and give God the praise that is due God's name. That's it. Stay right there for the next 60 seconds. Open your mouth all over the room. Lift your hands all over the room. And express to God the sentiments of your heart that bless God's name. Jesus said, if I be lifted up above the earth, I will draw all men unto me. I want you to take these next few moments and just lift the name of the Lord. Come on, everybody, let's get on one accord like an apostolic Pentecostal church. Pentecost, they were all one accord, one place. We're in one place, let's get on one accord. In this moment, in this space, in this place, have a personal Pentecost. Come on, everybody, everybody, close your eyes all over the room. Those of you all that are watching online, take a moment. If you're driving, don't close your eyes, keep driving. But center your spirit. Settle your soul. In this moment, in this space, in this place, thank you, praise team, for leading us into the presence now that we're in. Come on, it's you and God. Lift up the name of the Lord. Speak well of God to God. Let the God inside of you reach out to the God existential and connect in the power of the Holy Ghost in this moment, in this space, in this place. Continue to lift up the name of the Lord. God, your name is higher than any other name. We exalt your name. We extol your name. As people of your name who have experienced the power, the presence, and the peace . We honor you, God. We adore you, God. We magnify you, God. That means we see you bigger than our circumstance. Hallelujah. We magnify you and we see you bigger than our situation. Hallelujah. We magnify you, God, and we see you bigger than our circumstance. I don't know what your situation or what your circumstance may be, but I dare you to magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt God's name together. Magnify the Lord with me. The God we serve is bigger than our circumstance. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. The God we serve is bigger than our situation. The God we serve is bigger than the season that we are in right now. I thank the Lord for letting me get back home safe today so that I could say to my APC family, magnify the Lord with me. Because you don't know my situation. In and out, in and out. You don't know my circumstance. Woo. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I hear you. Speak, Lord. You don't know what season I am in. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Don't look at your neighbor. Those of y'all watching online, you don't have to type in the comments when I say this, because this is a command. Magnify the Lord with me. Here's what's significant about that scripture. Is you don't know what I'm going through. You don't know what season I'm in. You don't know what session I'm in. Whew, my God. Whoa, my. Oh, I felt the Holy Ghost over here on the third row. You don't know what circumstance, Sister Dee Dee, that I'm going through right now. So when I say to you, magnify the Lord with me. And guess what? With as much as I'm experiencing, with as difficult as my dilemma is in this moment right now, you only know what I told you that I needed you to pray with me about. Now you can do it. Type in the comments, you don't know, you don't know, you don't know. Look at your neighbor and say, you don't know, you don't know. You only know what I shared with you that I needed you to agree with me for God to check. But you don't know how it was affecting me. So what I need to know on today at 1:08 p.m. before we go any further, Minister Whitfield, good to see you on the front row. Amen. What you don't know is when I say to you, magnify the Lord with me, you don't know what I'm going through. Look at your neighbor and say, that part, that part. And furthermore, I can't tell you because it hurts to talk about it. Oh, my God, I hear Bishop E. But Jesus knows all about our struggles. And Jesus will guide till the day is done. I'm glad to know that in my situation, I'm not alone. Look at your neighbor and tell him, you're not alone. That's the first message that you need to hear on today. I don't know who that's for. I don't know who's watching, but I need you to know whatever season you're in, whatever session you're in, whatever circumstance you're going through right now, I need you to hear the word of the Lord. He that hath an ear, let them do what? He that hath an ear, let them do what? He that hath an ear, let them do what? You are not alone. God is there with you. You may feel like God is far away, but God says, no, I'm right here. I'm here to stay. I'm here to lead you. I'm here to guide you. I'm here to walk right beside you. And he, his name ain't Andy, his name is Jesus, but and he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me. Type in the comments, look at your neighbor. Now you can tell your neighbor. Tell him his name ain't Andy. His name is Jesus. I thought three people would have got excited when they said Jesus. I guess I had to go share this with somebody else. I'm sorry. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Let me share this with you. I'm going to move and then I'm done. I feel the Holy Ghost now. Y'all walk with me, talk with me, and we can get out of here. Magnify the Lord with, come on, Elder Sonia, you're catching it. She done caught it. Watch this. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I hear you. Ha, woo. All right. Holy Ghost just tapped me on my shoulder and brought something to my imagination and my illumination. Talk about imagination a little later on, but my imagination is what keeps me connected to God. Let me tell y'all this quick story. I'm gonna share a little bit of this lesson. I'm gonna share some nuggets. Y'all connect these dots. You're gonna get blessed and we're gonna get out of here. But magnify the Lord with me. Look at your neighbor and say, have you magnified your God? When I started driving, if y'all been here 7 years with me, high five me from your seat. Some of y'all done heard some of these stories. Elder Foster, I heard Bishop Smith say, that's how y'all know I'm aging, because I got stories to tell. I went to get my driver's license. I could already drive. I had been trained by some reputable drivers. In my family, right? My Uncle A.D. used to drive Greyhound buses. My daddy, y'all tell you, used to drive UPS. And when you get in Chicago, man, listen, you're going to sit at that light all day. You better get out in the intersection and get going. I heard all, I had to drive. Fast forward through the story. I go through driver's ed. I get instructed. Walk with me. I take the lessons. I get approved. Now I have to go to the state. The Department of Driver, I mean, the DMV. There you go. Y'all call it Secretary of State. We call it DMV. I had to go to the DMV, and I get in there, and they tell me, put your head in this little apparatus and tell us what you see. I said M. I said B. I said E. They said, that's three, that's D, that's B. I had gone through the process. I had a permit, but now I need a license to go to another level, to be able to experience the world in a way that I couldn't experience previously. Y'all walk with me and catch it. There were other experiences that were available for me, but I did not qualify for them because my perception was off. How many of us still have an antiquated perception of God, limiting what God wants to do for us because we can only see God through a lens that no longer serves the future that God has for us? This ain't for nobody in this church, because this is the beast. This is the PC church, not the BC church. God is taking us post-COVID. We're 100 years in what? We're 100 years in what? We're 100 years in what? So those of us that are moving beyond, we understand that we have to adjust our perception. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. My perception was off, even though I had permission to operate. But when I needed to go to another level and get a license, my perception had to be adjusted. I had to get corrective lenses. My vision had to be magnified. Some of y'all will catch it on the way home. I had a license in the previous season that didn't serve me in the season that God was taking me into. Furthermore, if I did not adjust my perception, I would never get the license to walk into another season. And you're trying to see a new thing through old lenses. Type it in the comments. Tell your neighbor, run it down your row. You will never see a new thing looking through old lenses. But I want to go back to the old time way. Why? When the Bible says that we move from faith to faith and from glory to glory. Look at your neighbor and say, we're moving. Look at your other neighbor and say, we're moving. In order for us to move, we must magnify the Lord. And when you magnify the Lord, it means that you adjust your perception. Whoo, my. You adjust your perception to see how God wants to manifest God's self in your current situation. Thank you, Brother Deal. High five me from your seat. I know I got one witness over here. I ain't even going into it, but you done had to change prescriptions a time or two, right? Huh? At least once. I seen you put your reading glasses on, right? I seen you with see, Brother Deal get up here and pray. He don't have his reading glass. But you asked him to read the Bible, he got to put his. I guarantee you this, the reading glasses he uses today are not the reading glasses he used. So Brother Deal, I want you to, you don't have to believe me, just remember I said it. Come here, shake my hand. God is getting ready to give you new vision. Watch this. For your children and your children's children and all your generations. God has heard your prayer. Lord, I'm going to stop because I hear it now. And woo, ha. Everybody say restoration. Restoration. Say, Lord, restore Brother Deal. Lord, restore Sister Deal. Say, Lord, restore the Deal family. Blessings, benefits, and benevolence beyond belief. Say, Lord, do it. High five three people and say, it's already done. It's already done. It's already done. Anthony, high five your wife. It's already done. Because you have been faithful. because of your faithfulness. And here's where I want 37 of y'all to get excited and say, since God is going to do it for Brother Deal, then God can do it for me too. I know he can. And I know he will. We believe too much and we know too little. But high five somebody and tell them, I've been faithful too. Don't say it if you ain't been faithful. Those of y'all watching online, type in the comments, I've been faithful too. Come on. High five your neighbor and tell them, I've been faithful too. And tell them, my blessing. All right, I got a little church in here today. Look at somebody and tell them, say, neighbor, I'm going to praise God with you, because the Bible says that I reckon that the sufferings of this present world shall not be compared. I feel Bishop E. Run it down your row and tell your neighbor, you got some glory coming. Tell them, I prophesied to you. You got some glory coming. The suffering that you endure shall not be prepared to the glory. Praise God for the glory. Praise God for the glory. The glory. Everybody lift your hands all over the room and say, Lord, I receive your glory. I got a lesson. I'll get to that later. But I want you to praise God for the glory. I see you, Sister Tambra. Praise God for the glory. The glory. The glory. I hear Bishop E now. You got some glory with your story. Tell your neighbor, there's some glory with your story. Type it on the comments. There is glory with your story. What's your story? What's your story? My story is I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shore. What's your story? But the master of the sea, he heard my despairing cry, and from the water he lifted me. What's your story? Now say, ooh, what's your story? What's your story? What's your story? What's your story? I'm gonna give you 60 seconds to go find three people and testify and tell them your story. What did God do for you? Why does God get the glory out of your life? What did God do for you? Did he heal your body? What did he do for you? What's your story? Did it save your soul? What did God do for you? What did he do for you? Testify and tell your story. What did God do for you? That's why my God gets the glory, because he saved my soul. Made me whole. Yes, he did. What did God do for you? He kept my mind. I'm looking at some of y'all, and y'all ought to be praising God better than that. Because I know you were between homicidal and suicidal. But is there anybody watching online? Is there anybody in this room that can tell God thank you and give God glory? Because he kept your mind. Yes, he did. You tried to give up on everything. You tried to give up on everybody. You threw in the towel, and the Lord threw it back to you and said, keep on fighting. He gives power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases strength. Go high five three people and say, neighbor, keep on fighting. You got strength. Keep on fighting. You got strength. Keep on fighting. Fight for your family. Fight for your prosperity. Fight for the victory that God has already given you.
Feel the glory of the Lord.
Let me fast forward through all of this lesson on today and summarize it in one point. And I promise, if y'all stay right there, don't sit down, y'all. I'm still standing. Y'all keep standing. We gonna get on the expressway and get out of here. Mama Wade is standing. Everybody here, y'all. Because I want you to catch. This was point two or three. I can't remember. My God. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Listen, this ain't my message. But here's how I'm going to preach it today. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, let's ride. The Holy Ghost hit me. Magnify the Lord. That thing hit me so hard because all of us are experiencing life in our own idiosyncratic patterns, our own individualistic, customized, genuine way. When you up, I'm down. When I'm down, you up. And sometimes it seems like we both talked about buke, scorn, pushed down, leveled almost to the ground. And then we have to find strength from somewhere. I'm in the lesson. Here's where I close. If I can't find strength in you, I got to find my strength in Jesus. Whew. Watch this. I know it's Palm Sunday, and we was waving our palms. But these palms represented What I want to share with you all on today, catch this and I promise we can get out of here. Whatever season, whatever session, whatever situation you are in, and it feels like you are struggling to get the victory in it, to get the victory through it, and to get the victory over it. Oh, see that? I just jumped ahead of myself. That was when we were supposed to dance. That's what I'm supposed to tell you. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, whatever you're struggling in, God is going to give you victory in it, victory through it, and victory over it. Whatever the season, whatever the session, whatever the circumstance. So get your palms, get your palms, get your palms. Get your palms, get your palms, get your palms. And I want to show you this. Here's my topic. Here's my topic, and I'm closing. Oh my God, I'm probably done. Yeah, give me. So listen, watch this. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it. We gonna get there. Hold it. Listen, hold it. Listen. I heard about this story from down south that said, hold it 1 second. We gonna get there 1 second. Hold it, Anthony. Listen, they said, those of y'all that are like me that was raised down south. How many of y'all was raised down south? That's, I know I got a seasoned church. Some of y'all are migrants. Y'all okay? We gonna talk. Lord bless the migrants in Jesus' name right now. All of them, they need help. Some of y'all migrated from down south. Some of y'all. Brother Nash, you know what I'm talking about when I talk about this. Nash, give me a good high five from your seat. There you go. Listen. They said some of y'all remember you used to get, you, when you wasn't acting right, you would get disciplined with a switch, right? With a switch. You did say I was raised up north, but my people's from down south. Y'all remember switches? I heard about one brother said he used to get it so bad, he said they would go get the soft switches. That means they was kind of green. They was like these leaves. They was a little flimsy. They had a little moisture. They wasn't ready to break yet. And said they would twist them up. Huh? Oh, I ain't got that. Mother Ella, you said that. Mother Ella said, amen. That's right. She knows some of it. And they would twist them up. Elder Sonny said they would braid them. All right, I'm done. Let me give y'all this. Jesus shows up for the triumphant entry. They have these palm trees. These palms represented certain things in spirituality. I'll talk about that later. But the one I want to talk about the close on today, because I'm in the close already, is somebody say victory. When you wave this palm, they were waving as a sign that our King was coming to give us. Woo! It wasn't everybody, but some of those people had the wrong perspective. And the ones who did not magnify the Lord with me, they cried Hosanna on Sunday. And by Friday, they had twisted their palms. What was initially a sign of a banner of victory had now become a sign of abuse. That wasn't in my notes. Yes. What was once a sign of victory, a banner of victory, has now been twisted into a sign of abuse. But here's what I want to close with on today. Here's my message, and I'm done, I promise. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, don't get it twisted. They had an agenda for Jesus because they were looking at Jesus through a minimized natural lens. Their perspective could only see Jesus coming to establish a political kingdom on earth. But what they did not know was God had another agenda. And here's the word that I need y'all to catch on today. When you show up in situations and circumstances, people are going to think that you showed up for the reason they wanted you to. But I need you to understand that when you show up in the power and the presence of the Holy Ghost. Not to do what people wanted you to do, not to do what people expected you to do. But you showed up ready to be used by God to do what God assigned and intended you to do. Come here, Samuel. Samuel heard the word and he didn't know what to do, so he went to the man of God, and the man of God said, next time you hear that voice, respond and say, here am I. Is there anybody in here on today that can say, that's my response? Here am I gotta get out of here. That's why you got saved, because God had a different agenda for you. Now, here am I. That's why you can't hang out with who you used to hang out with, because God has a different agenda for you. And God is calling you from where you were to where God wants you to be, because God has an assignment for your life. Will you respond? Here am I. I don't see myself worthy. I don't see myself valuable. But God, since you called me, here am I. I ain't got a license. I ain't got a collar. I ain't been anointed for ministry. But God, there's some people that are struggling with the same things that you delivered me from. God, here am I. Here comes Jesus saying, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, if it be thy will, here am I. I know the people that celebrate me today don't want to crucify me tomorrow. But God, since this is what you called me to do, here am I. Can I get 37 people to high-five me from your seat and say, I might not be what you want me to be. I might not be what you think I should be. But Lord, here am I. Use me, Lord, in thy service. Draw me nearer every day. Because if you use me, I'll be willing to run on all the way. High five your neighbor and let's close like a 100-year-old church and say, all the way with Jesus, I'm going. That person ain't get happy. They don't look like they going. Find somebody that's going to get happy like Brother Deal and say, Lord, I'm going all the way. I ain't been perfect. I ain't done everything right. Is there anybody that can testify like me? I done made some mistakes. I done made some missteps. But I'm glad that Jesus died to redeem me from every mistake, from every misstep, from every mishap. I'm redeemed. I'm reconciled.
Lord, I'm
sorry. Ain't none of y'all ever sinned since you've been saved. But if there's anybody like me that can thank God that even though you sinned since you've been saved, that the blood of Jesus cleanses us. That's why we take a communion Thursday. Because the blood of Jesus cleanses us. That's what y'all told me. That's what my Bible said. Cleanses us from all unrighteousness and makes us worthy. Magnify the Lord with me. You ain't got to magnify it like I had to magnify it. Because you ain't been through what I've been through. You ain't had to magnify it like I had to magnify it. Because you ain't been caught in what I've been caught in. But if there's anybody in this church today that knows God is a redeemer, God is a restorer, y'all should be praising God better than that. Because I know some of your story, and for 100 years, he's been redeeming you. You relapsed last week, and he redeemed you this week. You fell short last month, and he redeemed you this month. Anybody, everybody, somebody ought to praise him, because you got a God that you can magnify.
Come on, APC, that's a spot right there to put your hands together. You might as well dance and glorify.
You got 20 seconds to give a great God a great praise. Magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt God's name together, for the Lord is good. And we magnify the Lord, and we lift up the name. Thank God that the God that you magnify is the God that delivers, the God that heals, the God that restores, the God that sets free. And if there's anybody in here or anybody watching online that you know that you've been healed, you've been restored, and you've been made whole. You've been healed, you've been restored, and you've been made whole. Well, Sister Ambassadors done got to going. Y'all, come on, give it. 1, 2, 3, come on! Delivered and restored. Woo, thank you, Jesus. Type in the comments, those of you all watching online. Everybody in the room, tell your neighbor, healed, delivered, and restored. Healed, delivered, and restored. Oh. Healed, delivered, and restored. Do me a favor. Grab one neighbor by the hand and grab it tight with conviction. In the church I grew up in, they said, look them eyeball to eyeball and say, neighbor, I'm going to praise God with you because you've been healed, you've been delivered, and you've been restored. Healed, delivered, Anthony, and restored. Healed, delivered, type it in the comments. Healed, delivered, and restored. Healed, delivered, and restored. Delivered and restored. That's it. I see you. I see you, Elder Brandon. Healed, delivered, and restored. Sister Cassandra, healed, delivered, and restored. God bless you. Pastor Dana, healed, delivered, and restore. Those that are watching online, we pray and believe and know that you have felt the power of God and you have been blessed by this ministry online as we've been ministering to you. We thank you for joining on with us. Again, share with your neighbor, we are healed, we are delivered, and we are restored.